Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be making a fabric backed plate, or it's also known as reverse decoupage. The supplies that you need for this is a glass plate, a coffee can or something to prop your plate on while you're working on it, Mod Podge, a sponge brush, some scissors, some glaze to seal the fabric when you're done, and then your fabric. Now, I like to use what's called fat quarters or quarter squares. You can get these at several places. Walmart has them, Michael's has them, but Joann's has the biggest selection of quarter squares that I have ever seen. If anybody has gone into Joann's and gone into their fabric department, up against the walls are little pockets, and they're just filled with these little squares. And this is how they come. This one is from Joann's. This is from Walmart. Walmart has a small selection of them, and they're nice. They're different ones, some superheroes, and different types of things. I also got this one at Walmart, and I think because it's a seasonal, this is for Halloween, that they roll them, and they may have them in a special little area in the fabric department. And this one is from Michael's. Now, Michael's has just a few, not too many, but they're all the same size. They are all 18 by 21 inches, no matter how they're folded or rolled. So they go from anywhere from 97 cents to probably like $1.47, I think I paid for these. Don't remember exactly, maybe $1.49 at Michael's. But if you watch the sales at Joann's, sometimes they put these fat quarters on sale and give them for a really good deal. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to open this since Halloween is coming. I've been working on some Halloween plates. This is a pretty good piece of fabric here. It's a nice size. So we're going to be working with this one today. So we're going to start by taking our plate, and these glass plates, I used to be able to find these at Dollar Tree years ago. I would get these, and for some reason they stopped carrying them. So Walmart also carries them. I think they're $1.50 at Walmart. Not too bad. But recently I found them again at Dollar Tree. So I was really, really happy about that, and I stocked up on them before they disappear again. So we're going to start by putting our plate upside down on our coffee can. And we're going to fold it back a bit with Mod Podge. And don't worry about how much you put on here, because even though it goes on white, it dries clear, so you're not going to be able to see it on the fabric. But we need a good coat of this on here in order to seal the fabric to the plate. I've been making these for a long time. I started by making them as teacher gifts. I thought it was a unique idea, something a little bit different. And they make really nice hostess gifts also with the holidays coming, and the pretty, pretty fabric that they have out for fall and winter. You could actually make one of these as a hostess gift, fill it with candy or homemade brownies or cookies, wrap it in cellophane, and put a bow on it. And not only did you bring a nice homemade treat, but you also brought a beautiful homemade personal item for the hostess. I made some of these as Christmas presents last year too, and you can even tailor it to someone's specific likes. The person I made it for happens to like Mickey Mouse, so I was able to find Mickey Mouse material being in Florida. That was really easy for me. And I made her a Mickey plate with some homemade fudge, and she really, really liked that. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take our fabric and we're going to put it upside down. You want to put the print side down on the back of the plate so that the print, when you turn it over, the print will show up. Now, if you have a specific, if there's a specific pattern or something that you really like on the fabric that you want to show, you'll want to position it in the middle of your plate and get that particular piece of fabric. But this being all ghosts, I'm not concerned about that. So I'm just going to put this and let it hang over the edges just a little bit. And we're going to smooth this down as much as we can. I want to work out all the bubbles. Make sure there's no creases in here. For several hours so that the fabric will adhere to the plate. If I do these in the morning, I'll let them sit until I get home from work, and they're usually good to go down. If I make them at night, I just let them sit overnight. And I'm going to cut some of this extra fabric off that we don't need. These are just so, so easy to make. So there's still a pretty good piece of fabric left. Might be able to, well, you could use it for a smaller dessert plate or something. Make something else. So we're going to let this sit overnight. And this is what we have so far. But we're going to let it sit and dry. So I'm going to scoop that one out of the way. And I had done another one and let it dry. And this is what this one is looking like so far. As you can see, all the Mod Podge dried. There's nothing white. You can't see any of that. It goes on white and dries clear. And what we're going to do now is we're going to trim all of this as close to the plate as we possibly can. These plates is with all the Mod Podge that you'll be using and the sealer on it, they become super strong. I've dropped them on the floor, finished ones, and they didn't even crack at all. I was really, really surprised at how strong they are when all the sealant is on it. Just going to keep cutting this as close as we can. That we get all the little rough edges off too. Maybe if there's any strings or anything hanging, we want to cut those. Okay. that's our plate. We've cut that excess material off. Now what I like to do is I like to put one more coat of Mod Podge just around the end here, just to make sure that these are sealed really, really good. So you're basically using two coats. And I wouldn't worry about up here. This is really, it's sealed really well up there. So I wouldn't worry about that. But I would get just all the way down and like around here, around the edges. And just make sure that that's sealed good to the glass. Just gonna let this dry too. I usually try to make several of them at a time just because they are time consuming. With all the drying time in between, they are time consuming, so I'll make four or five at a time, and that makes it a little bit easier to finish them. So I've sealed that all the way around. I'm gonna put that aside and I'm gonna let that dry too. And then our last part of this is we want to seal the back with this clear glaze. So I had another plate that I had done earlier, and same thing. I did my first step with the Mod Podge on the plate and putting the fabric on. I let it dry overnight. I trimmed it and sealed it again. And then I took this outside earlier. I sealed the back of it. I just put a light coat of spray on it and I let it dry, and now this plate is good to go. So very, very simple, very, very easy. This is another Halloween one that I had done too. Like I said, I do a couple of them at a time. Same process, it's all sealed, nice and strong, and ready to go. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope that you'll think about making some if you have teachers to give to, or if you just have someone that's really hard to buy for. Even if you go to a football party, Super Bowl parties in a few months will be coming up, you could make a football plate. There's team fabric that you could use on these, so they can be personalized to fit the person that you're giving it to. There's so many different options. I think it's a nice gift. It's something they can keep forever. There's even little stands they can set it up on and display it. So I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And until next time, I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.